Hey now, Rodney R. Dixon here with a word of warning to anybody considering buying an iPhone 4. We're not talking an iPhone 4S, but an iPhone 4 instead of an iPhone 5. I have frequently used an iPhone 5 to make speakerphone telephone calls as I am driving my vehicle. Essentially, what I'll do is, given where I live, we have strict laws whereby we cannot operate a mobile cellular device as we are operating a mobile vehicle. Therefore, what I'll do is before I actually take off, I actually begin to drive, I'll place my initial call, I'll enable speakerphone, I'll then place the iPhone 5 in a storage compartment of my dashboard where it can actually face my mouth. And I essentially speak into the phone and listen to the other party hands-free as I drive my car. I've used the iPhone 5 on numerous occasions, and the phone quality, the call quality was generally, well, it was generally good. It was, in fact, always good. I've never had an issue. Well, as of recent, I had to opt to use an iPhone 4. Once again, this is a newly issued iPhone 4. It is an iPhone 4 8GB, destined for the budget market. Not to say that it's an old iPhone 4 from many years back. Important to note, on the exact same network as the iPhone 5 I frequently use, on the same service plan, billed to the same person, used at the same time of day, used in the same vehicle, used on the same route even. So as per usual, I have the iPhone 4 with me instead of the iPhone 5. What do? Place the same call I place all the time. First thing I note, enabling speakerphone. The speakerphone is much lower. The volume output, even when turned up to the max, is much lower compared to what the iPhone 5 can do. Nonetheless, I could still make out what the other party is saying. Fine, I'll put up with it. Put the iPhone 4 in my designated storage compartment and begin driving. Well, if you've done any research into the iPhone 4 versus the iPhone 5, you must have come across the placement of the antennas on each, whereby on the iPhone 4, the placement of the antennas were problematic and did not receive good reception. On the iPhone 5, they were more advantageously positioned to capture a better signal. Well, this showed in droves during this test. As it turns out, the phone call quality was terrible. Once again, both of these phones on the exact same network, on the exact same plan, billed to the exact same person, driven in the exact same vehicle, exact same time of day, exact same duration. When I was trying to communicate over the speakerphone call on the iPhone 4, I had to give up within 2 minutes of the call. The phone call quality was so poor. The other party was continually breaking up and disappearing. And when I say disappearing, I'm not talking about just minor skips. I'm talking about whole sentences were just not being delivered. It was just silence for most of the attempt to make a phone call. I basically, like I said, after around 2 minutes, just gave up and ended the call. It just wasn't working out. So let that be a lesson to you. Let that be a caution. If you're thinking about buying an iPhone 4 instead of an iPhone 5 due to budgetary concerns. Yeah, well, there are actually improvements that went into the iPhone 5, and one of which being call quality, especially speakerphone call quality in a moving vehicle, is greatly ameliorated on an iPhone 5 versus an iPhone 4. Not to mention, just a side note, unrelated, but I find the fact that you cannot natively within the iOS dictate a message and have the iOS translate it from speech into text. For example, you cannot speak your SMS text messages nor your emails into an iPhone 4. You need apparently an iPhone 4S in order to do so. I always thought that was frankly deplorable. I mean, I could use speech-to-text functionality in a $50 Android phone. I don't know why I can't do it in a $400 iPhone. It doesn't make any sense to me. But anyway, just one of the many reasons that if you're absolutely going to stick with iPhone, because, you know, you don't want to go into Android. I don't know, I'm an Android fan, so I'm obviously going to defend Android, but I understand that people who are diehard iPhone fans will not convert. That's fine. Listen, if you're going to go with iPhone, there's actual reasons to go with the iPhone 5, including various ameliorations such as call quality. Well, there you go. I hope that information helps, and as usual, all the best.